To celebrate, let's take the wrap off a brand new Loop Deck CT. The surface you'll be manipulating is below this felt cover. The USB-C holder and user guide will be next. Then, you may get the Loop Deck program for your PC or Mac by visiting loopdeck.com. If you've never used Loop Deck before, the full capability of your console can only be unlocked after you've registered it. To sign up for Loop Deck, go to https://account.loopdeck.com. Please enter your email address and click the Send Verification Code button to continue with the sign-up process. After that, you may establish your Loop Deck account by filling out the remaining information. Signing up using your social media accounts is an option as well. Currently, sign-in through Facebook, Google, Razer, and Twitch are all supported. To begin setting up, double-click the downloaded file. After installing the plugin, a system restart is required for optimal functionality. To use your Loop Deck CT once again after resetting the firmware, connect it to your Mac using the USB-C connector and wait for it to load up. After connecting the CT, launch the Loop Deck Setup program from the computer's menu or taskbar. If you're using a Mac, as I am, we should make sure the Loop Deck program can launch. To accomplish this, go to the Settings menu. Simply choose the Privacy and Security tab. Locate the option labeled Accessibility and choose it. The next thing to do is to ensure that the box next to Loop Deck is checked. If it doesn't, you may force it to after unlocking your preferences and selecting it. Once this is done, go up to the upper right corner. To use Loop Deck, choose the icon. To access setup, please scroll down. That link is right here, so just go ahead and click it. The list of available programs may be found in the lower left corner, and the tour guide can be triggered at any time. Through the Loop Deck software, you can go back to how the software is set up at any time. I'd like to introduce you to the new and improved user interface of Loop Deck 5.2. You may change your workspace, profile, and device settings from the menu at the top. You'll also have access to your account settings in the brand new Loop Deck shop, where you can get profiles, plugins, and icon packs, among other things, for your Loop Deck CT device. The device view allows you to observe the many components of the console. You may choose between touch buttons, dials, and conventional buttons on the Loop Deck CT. Workspaces, touchscreen pages, and dial pages may all be accessed with a single click. Another option is to make your own. The modernized action panel, where you may create, browse, search, and filter actions, can be found on the right. You may also choose which plugins are shown on your profile and assign your workspaces and pages to buttons from this section. In both Mac OS and Windows, they provide default profiles for several programs, and new profiles may be created for any program, with adding new details to old profiles. When the dynamic mode is enabled, the device's profile is updated dynamically depending on the currently running program. The dynamic mode may be turned on and off manually through the device. You may access existing workspaces and create new ones from the main menu. You can access your various work areas and assign them to buttons in the Actions panel. To toggle between workspaces or alter button color, just click one of the circular buttons and change it. Create new touchscreen pages or dial pages and navigate between them easily inside your workstation. The gadget allows you to rearrange the items in whatever order you choose. Alter their names and remove them. To navigate between pages, just glide your finger over the screen or use the buttons in the bottom navigation bar. Unless another profile is specified or a compatible program is launched, the operating system will utilize the main profile by default. My primary profile Mac default may be thought of as a generic profile since it remains in effect whenever an application profile is not in use or when dynamic mode is turned off until a different profile is explicitly activated. For example, open Capture One, Illustrator, or Lightroom Classic on your computer when dynamic mode is turned on your Loop Deck device. The corresponding profile will immediately become active on your computer. Tailoring the main profile to your own requirements is when the fun begins. You may build the ideal collection of controls by including any combination of desktop, custom, and universal plugin actions. Let's have a look at the many function categories that might be included in your primary profile. The workspaces are organized in the home space in accordance with the Final Cut Pro process I use. Aside from the audio and color grading, I also did the organization. Before I get into the workspaces, I wanted to give a quick shout out to Sergam because of his in-depth review and assessments, not once, but twice on this product over the last 2 years, I was compelled to buy it. You'll find both of his video links will be in the description box below. First, let's take a look at the Loop Deck CT console. This controller includes a main scroll wheel with a touch interface inside 6 hard buttons on both sides of the wheel, and another 8 buttons above it. At the top, you get 6 more dials, which also are push buttons that you can press down, and 12 virtual touch screen buttons between the dials. My favorite is that you can assign specific functions to each button to fit your workflow. In this video, I will focus on using the Loop Deck CT with Final Cut Pro, but this controller can also be used with other apps like Premiere Pro, Photoshop, Lightroom, DaVinci Resolve, and so much more. Let's install Command Post to make the most out of this console. Click on the Marketplace button. Select Plugins and find Command Post. Click on Learn More and download and install this plugin. The Command Post adds several beneficial features to Final Cut Pro, including a scrolling timeline, movable markers, and watch folders. And the best part is that it's completely free. After installing Command Post, click on its icon in the menu bar, go to Control Surfaces, and select the Loop Deck plugin. In the next window, check the Enable Loop Deck plugin box and close the settings window. Next, back in the Loop Deck software, go back to the Marketplace, select the Profiles tab, scroll down and find Final Cut Pro with Command Post. Download and install this profile. This profile comes with 3 sets of default controls for Final Cut Pro, one for editing, one for color, and one for audio. The sweet thing is that you can personalize your buttons even more and customize them to fit your workflow. Let's start with the main scroll wheel by default. The main scroll wheel moves your playhead with a touch interface inside used as a play pause button. If you click on this wheel in this software, you can personalize it to your liking. Click on the 3 dots under the scroll wheel and add a new page. What I like to do is have it set up for 4 2x2 buttons. To assign these buttons, go to the sidebar on your right hand side, select the Final Cut Pro controls, and use the search bar at the top to search for frame. I'll set up my number 1 button to navigate 1 frame at a time. Grab the Navigate 1 Frame setting and drag and drop it over the top of button 1. I'll set the number 2 button to navigate 10 frames. The number 3 button to navigate between the edit by selecting Next Edit. Lastly, I'll set the number 4 button to nudge audio subframe. I'll also move this up to the top to make it my default setting. So now, in Final Cut Pro, if I want precision navigation, I just tap Navigate 1 frame and use a scroll wheel to move my playhead by 1 frame. If I want to move around faster, I tap Navigate 10 frames or select Edit and move my playhead around much quicker. If I want to nudge my audio, I tap on button 4 and just like that, I can nudge my audio in either direction. Setting up buttons is very similar. Select the button to see what is currently assigned to it. And if you want to change it, just click on the X to remove the current preset. Then search for the control you want to assign to it and drag and drop it over the open spot. You can assign up to 2 functions for each button, the right arrow button. For example, I used to blade my clip in the timeline. I'll add the blade at playhead at the top spot and the blade all for the bottom slot. In Final Cut Pro, if I want to blade a clip in my timeline, I just tap the right arrow key on my Loop Deck. If I want to blade all clips in my timeline to access the second function of the button, I just hold down the function key and tap the right arrow button. Also, the round buttons can be set up this way as well. Next up is a touch screen buttons. I use these for controls that I use in all my projects. This is where Command Post comes in clutch. It gives you a ton of extra controls you can access with Loop Deck controls or keyboard shortcuts. For example, when I frame my clip, I often use a horizon overlay and save zones for my lower third callouts. To enable the horizon overlay, I have to go to View and select Show Horizon, then go back into View and select Save Zones. That's the only way to do it in Final Cut Pro. You don't even have the option to add a keyboard shortcut for this command. But if you have Command Post, you can set it up to come on and off with 1 button. One issue I've been having with my Loop Deck CT is that, at times, my safe zones will get stuck and I can't disable them. So if I really want them disabled, I have to shut down Final Cut and reopen it. So this is definitely a con in my book. If you use the Loop Deck CT and have a similar problem, please let me know how you fixed it in the comments. I created a macro to enable both the safe zones and horizon simultaneously, so that could be the issue. If you want just the horizon, in the Loop Deck software, select the command post controls, search for horizon, and drag and drop this command to assign it to one of the buttons. Same thing for the safe zones. This makes it so much easier. Another dope feature for command posts is the ability to assign a specific title, transition, or effect to a button. For example, I use call out saying subscribe from Motion VFX all the time. You can just search for the subscribe call to action 9, select the call out, and then add it to a button. When I need to apply to my project, instead of going through all the steps, I just tap the button, which makes it so much faster than looking for this particular plugin and dragging it to the timeline. Take a look at what I have set up for myself. As you can see, I have my most commonly used commands set at my fingertips, which enables my editing process to become much faster. With the Loop Deck CT, you also have different workspaces. So depending on your editing stage, your buttons and dials can also have different functions, like adjusting your audio or using specific controls for color correction. As mentioned before, besides assigning individual controls to each button, the Loop Deck CT allows you to make a chain of commands called macros and assign those macros to a single button. Let me show you one of the macros I have set up on my Loop Deck. I usually use a 10 frame gap clip when editing my intros before my voiceovers start. Also, I use a 10 frame gap clip to gather my spacing or to create a pause between topics. To create this macro to alleviate all of the command inputs on my timeline, I press the following. Go over to the custom tab, then hit multi-action macro and start recording your commands. Name the action, select action type, keyboard shortcut, click on the shortcut section, press option plus W, add action, choose action type, keyboard shortcut, click on the shortcut section, press right arrow on your keyboard, add action, choose action type, keyboard shortcut, click on the shortcut section, press C, add action, choose action type, keyboard shortcut, click on the shortcut section, press control plus D, add action, choose action type, keyboard shortcut, click on the shortcut section, press 1, add action, choose action type, keyboard shortcut, click on the shortcut section, press 0, add action, choose action type, keyboard shortcut, press return or enter, then click save. Your macro is saved and ready to be added to one of your buttons on your Loop Deck CT. Once saved, drag it to one of your buttons, and now this action is set to one of your buttons. Next time you need to add a 10 frame gap clip, instead of going through all the listed steps, just press this button, and it's like magic. Your 10 frame gap clip is added to your timeline. Another quick macro I added that I use in my workflow is Control 5 plus 1. Control 5 is the shortcut for clip appearance. Film strip and Control 1 is the shortcut to adjust the waveforms. So now I can switch back and forth view my audio from my footage. Again, this comes in clutch with my editing workflow. Before I give this product my honest review, I want to change this multi-action function of displaying the horizon plus safe zones. Snapping is a better bet for my workflow. Like I said before, it's just that easy. Plug and play, once you have all of your buttons set up, it's on to the races. This video is not sponsored by the creators over at Loop Deck, but hopefully soon I'll be able to conduct more reviews about their products. Now let's get to the honest review. I didn't even scratch the surface of what the Loop Deck CT can put out, but trust me, there are many more programmable options to help speed up your workflow using the Loop Deck CT. Let's break down the pros and cons first. Would I recommend this product to a newly consistent video editor? The answer is no, and here's why. For starters, the price alone is very steep to say the least. The Loop Deck CT is priced at $549, but is an excellent add-on for photographers, videographers, musicians, and others who work in creative applications. It mixes physical dials and keys with programmable touch functions, delivering a powerful, extensible control experience. It's a better fit for workstations rather than most mobile editors, but it can improve your workflow. The asking price is steep, but the Loop Deck CT offers functionality that competing products can't even match, which is a plus in my book. Honestly, I've been eyeing the Loop Deck CT since the end of 2020, and 2 years later, I pulled the plug and bought this lovely controller. The Loop Deck CT is the second major hardware design from the company. Unfortunately, it's a desktop console, not one for mobile editing, with a footprint that's bigger than Apple's second generation Magic Trackpad and a lot smaller than the original Loop Deck keyboard. The CT measures 1.2 by 5.9 by 6.3 inches height, width and depth, and weighs 12.9 ounces. It ships with a braided USB-C to USB-C cable to plug it into your Mac or PC. The hardware includes Bluetooth, but it's not activated with the current firmware. Wireless operation is impossible, though, as the hardware doesn't include a battery. I connected the CT to my iMac M1 with Mac OS Ventura and use it primarily with Final Cut Pro X, which is the creative app I use the most. But don't get it twisted, whenever I pull up Adobe Lightroom or Photoshop, the custom presets switch over right as I click on the app. Other profiles are preloaded for other apps too, including Ableton Live, Phase 1 Capture One Pro, and a number of Adobe apps like Audition, Illustrator, Lightroom Classic, Photoshop, and Premiere Pro, just to name a few just for reference. Lastly, if you buy the Loop Deck CT from their website, you get a 45-day satisfaction guarantee and all of your money back. So, in conclusion, my biggest complaint is with the customization process and Loop Deck software in general, is that it's not very intuitive to use, and what you can or cannot do is not always apparent. In addition, functions vary based on what workspace you're using in your creative app. Not to mention again, the price is high for beginning editors. I would suggest, if willing to purchase, save up for this product first before purchasing. Also, I'm running my Loop Deck CT with a USB-C cord, and the delay between the console and whatever I'm trying to search during setup takes a little bit of time to load, which can be frustrating. Overall, it's a fantastic product if you can afford it. The price for me is not a must buy, but I will continue to use the Loop Deck CT in my editing workflow. Remember to tune into the Dish Riz Entertainment Cinematic YouTube channel every Thursday to view all of my throwback videos I've completed over the years, and Fridays, where I upload new content. This is the first episode of What's in My Camera Bag, where I break down the different products I use when filming, plugins, and consoles to help speed up my workflow. Let me know if you enjoyed the video, and if you have a Loop Deck yourself, and which one do you have? Should I buy the Loop Deck Live for on-the-go editing? Drop a comment below and send me some links on products you would like me to review in the future. Send all product review links to Dish Riz Cinematic Reviews at dishrizcinematicreviews@gmail.com. Please smash those like and subscribe buttons on your way out. Drop a comment below if you liked the video and if you have any advice on future products to review. Thanks for watching. Until next time, Jessica O, take us out. Peace.
Thank you for tuning in to Dish Riz Studio Productions YouTube channel. Feel free to like and subscribe to my channel, which enables my production team to keep producing fire content like what you just viewed. Also, follow me on social media to stay up to date with what's new or future projects. Find me on social media on Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter at DizRizENT. Business website, www.dizrizent.com. Take care. Peace.